Okay, my call is in order. First item is roll call.
Alderman Arnold.
Here.
Alderman Headley.
Here.
Alderman Hollister.
Here.
Alderman Letts.
Here.
Alderman Johnson.
Here.
Alderman Payne.
Here.
Next item, the invocation from Pastor Gerald Jones from Crossroads Church, followed by pledge allegiance from Alderman Headley.
Let's pray together. God, we give you thanks. Great weather, great week, and we've had a great weekend as a community. And so I just pray your blessings tonight over the business that is at hand and over those that will transact the business. Thank you for these servants, these city employees, and these aldermen, our mayor, and just for the hard work and effort that they put into to managing our city and to doing what's best for our community. So bless them tonight as they work and serve for the betterment of everyone involved. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic over which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, next item is approval of the agenda.
Mr. Mayor, we'd like to add a ordinance to the agenda. It'll be D15-19. This ordinance approving the purchase of the property from B&L Bank.
I'll entertain a motion to amend the agenda to add Bill D15-19. Question from Alderman Headley, who has a second? Second, Alderman Bailey, in session. Okay, none, all in favor of amending the agenda, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say aye. Okay, no proclamations, move on to citizen participation. We ask the citizens to step forward to the microphone and podium and address the board. Just give your name and address for the record. Anyone who wants to sit here up for the morning team? Okay, now move on to the agenda. I have a motion from Alderman West to approve the consent agenda. Five and second. Second, Alderman Hanley. Any discussion? Okay, none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign. Okay, no previous business, new business. We'll move on to discussion regarding the Grand Valley Athletic Association's facility use agreement.
Mr. Mayor, members of the board, received an executed copy of the contract for Grand Valley Athletic Association this afternoon. I knew it would be coming in, but that's the only reason we didn't add it to the agenda. I wanted to make sure that we had that before we actually placed the resolution. So on the back of this resolution that you have in front of you is the executed copy of the contract. This is the contract that in executive session the board will staff to proceed with. We sent that to GBA, and that's what you guys agreed. So we'll be happy to have any discussion about it. Before the end of discussion, if you would like to amend the agenda and add this resolution to the agenda, one of the board members would need a motion to do that.
Do you have any questions or comments regarding the contracts?
Yeah, the contract is, this is the most recent contract that we discussed in the last book.
And if they agree to all terms, I make a motion to put on within the building.
Is that the resolution?
Yes, we got it.
I have a motion of Alderman Johnson to add resolution R15-64 to tonight's agenda. So I have a second. Second, Alderman Headley. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor of adding to the agenda, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, opposed, same sign. You just want to step on that, no, in the session?
First, that would be pretty good, isn't it?
Okay, number six, move on to ordinances.
Mayor, Bill B, 1518, first reading. Is an ordinance to establish the City of Green Valley, Missouri annual tax levies for the 2015 calendar year for general municipal government operations, retirement of general obligation debt, park, and public health purposes. First reading, Bill B, 15-18.
Mayor, I move that we accept ordinance Bill B, 15-18, first reading, bring it back for second reading by title only.
I have a motion, Alderman West, to approve Bill B, 15-18, for its first reading, bring it back by title only for its second reading. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second, Alderman Arnold. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign.
6-0, first reading, Mayor. Bill B, 15-19, first reading. An ordinance approving the purchase by the City of Green Valley, Missouri of real property from B&L Bank, authorizing the city administrator to execute all necessary documents required to effectuate and close said transaction, including loan documents, and a budget amendment to allow for purchase. First reading, Bill B, 15-19, is on for a second reading as a purchase.
Mayor, move that we accept Bill 15-19 for its first reading, bring it back for its second reading by title only.
I have a motion from Alderman Arnold to approve Bill B, 15-19 for its first reading, bring it back by title only for its second reading. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second, Alderman Dudley. Any discussion?
Mr. Mayor, members of the board, we've had numerous discussions about this property. This will just allow for the city to close on the property tomorrow at 10 a.m. The amendment to the budget, you'll notice that it includes that $750,000. The reason that it's $750,000 is the purchase price is $725,000. Because we have estimates just remediated, it's going to be about $25,000 to go ahead and get ready to prevent further damage from break-ins, any mold, mildew, and winterize for the year.
Any discussion?
Have we got any more commitment on the portion of the property on the line?
Yes, I met on September 1st with that board and their closed session as well. So we take it to their full board of trustees at their next meeting, which is definitely another week after the 21st. That being said, we can, if you'd like to talk about that tomorrow, we can talk about it in the next session.
Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign.
Aye.
Second, you opposed?
Yes.
Second reading, Bill B, 15-19, it will be ordinance 2367. Second reading, an ordinance approving the purchase by the City of Green Valley, Missouri of real property from B&L Bank, and authorizing the city administrator to execute all necessary documents required to effectuate and close said transaction, including loan documents and a budget amendment to allow for purchase. Second reading, ordinance 2367.
Mayor, move that we accept Bill 15-19 for second reading and make it ordinance 2367.
I have a motion, Alderman Arnold, to approve Bill B, 15-19 for its second reading, make an ordinance 2367. Do I have a second? Second, Alderman West. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign.
Aye.
Arnold?
Yes.
Johnston?
Yes.
Stanley?
Yes.
Edlich?
Yes.
Malachek?
Yes.
West?
Yes.
5-1, Mayor.
Something else?
Okay.
Mayor, I
There are resolutions on, I want to read some of those, right, wait, sir.
First one, I just hold that. I'm sorry, I need to read the first few of those.
Resolution R 15-58, which is a resolution by Board of Aldermen, City of Green Valley, approving the 2016 annual budget for the Green Valley Marketplace Community Improvement Division. Resolution R 15-58.
I move that we accept resolution R 15-58.
I have a motion, Alderman Bud, to approve resolution R 15-58. Do I have a second? Second, Alderman Hollenshead. Any discussion?
I mean, neither of these properties are included in the void of the multiple.
Yes. Which is the, Green Valley Marketplace, the cinema, and the.
Any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign.
Six, zero. Resolutions, R 15-59, 15-60, 15-61, 15-62, which are resolutions of the Board of Aldermen, City of Green Valley, Missouri, appointing respectively Christopher Bowman and Michael Hackett to the Green Valley, Missouri Tax Increment Financing TIF Commission for a four-year term. Darrell Jones for a two-year term. Dave Halpin, four-year term. And Steve Westerman, four-year term. All resolutions for appointment to the Green Valley, Missouri TIF Commission for the respective terms.
Mayor, I move that we accept resolution R 15-59, R 15-60, R 15-61, and R 15-62.
I have a motion, Alderman Bud, to approve resolution R 15-59 through R 15-62. Do I have a second? Second, Alderman Kessley. Any discussion?
Yeah, there's actually a two-year appointment. The original resolution said for this situation. This is summary that we want to be like two years and a half.
Question or discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign.
Resolution R 15-63 is a resolution by the Board of Aldermen, City of Green Valley, Missouri, authorizing the mayor to enter into a memorandum agreement with Mark LaVoy, Public Information Services. Resolution R 15-63.
Mayor, I move to accept resolution 15-63.
I have a motion, Alderman Kessley, to approve resolution R 15-63. Do I have a second? Second, Alderman Stanley. Any discussion?
Mr. Mayor, members of the board, I'd like to introduce Mark LaVoy to the board and have him vote in just a little bit of history and background and experience in journalism.
Thank you very much. I'm going to take a couple of minutes to introduce myself to Mayor Todd, to the board. Very quickly, I know we're getting close to the end of the meeting. I have a couple of decades experience as a broadcast journalist and news writer. A lot of that, everything comes from the written word, and that's going to be a lot to do with what I do for the city here tonight. For the past year and a half, I've been the managing editor of Kansas City Morning News on KMBZ Radio. If you listen there, you've probably heard my voice before. My career involves close to two decades at KFBI and Wichita, Kansas. Important state, station in the state of Kansas, too many awards to count, and it's been a great opportunity and a learning experience for me for several years. Major focus on my work over the years has been in news writing, and beginning as a writing coach, I've worked with dozens of coworkers over the years to improve their writing providing a lot of information for the public and for you guys. Just appreciate any guidance you give me in that regard. Variety of needs, local government, education, police, fire, severe weather, everything you can name under the sun. So I have a broad level of experience. Also, a media training volunteer for local law enforcement in the Wichita area. That's a metropolitan statistical area, about a half million people. And basically, my job was to go with new police sergeants and fire chiefs and that sort of thing, assist them and deal better with the media. Making them more comfortable with that and helping them better get their message forward to the public. Basically, my main idea is to form a symbiotic partnership with local government and news media, and I'd just like to thank you in advance for any guidance that you provide me and help me to serve the city. I'd be glad to answer any questions you may have for me.
Any questions? Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Mr. Mayor, I would just like to add that the contract is taking a position that Chris Claus previously held, and she moved on to the other real estate project that she worked on, so the commission. When I talked to Chris about it, she didn't give me a list of people she worked with, but Mark was the person to talk to. Leila and I brought in this with just about what the priority and how much of a priority for the information is with the board of Aldermen, and feels comfortable with that challenge.
Seeing none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, same sign.
Resolution 15-64 is a resolution by the Board of Aldermen, City of Green Valley, Missouri, authorizing the mayor or his designee to enter into a field usage agreement with Green Valley Athletic Association, GVAA. First reading, resolution R15-64.
Mayor, move to resolution 15-64. I have a motion of Aldermen Dillon to approve resolution R15-64. Do I have a second? Second from Palaszczuk. Any discussion?
That was just a misspoken resolution on that first reading.
This is a resolution.
Yeah, resolution.
What read?
Is this just covered football?
This field use agreement has covered it. So it's football, baseball, softball, T-ball.
Motion on the floor for a table of resolution R15-64 from Alderman Arnold. Second on the motion table.
Second.
Second on the Stanley. Any discussion?
The parcel under 990 that was included with the report that they submitted. The report speak of the schedule G, the schedule O, that are part of that document, which has been provided. basically what we're going to be asking for from them annually to prove their financial stability. In the practice of getting all the information that we request. No, I sent emails to Dave Alvin, the representative, and that was the reason why they provided the 990 that they had provided. And when I viewed and saw that there was information there that was included along with those reports, I asked for those additional schedules that were mentioned in the report so we could review that as well.
Right, you already came back, I know you keep us on the email.
Yeah, I
can't remember what Dave got out of the email.
Dave was asked about it again last week, originally, and Alvin and I discussed it. He said we would look at NARA, then with Nathan Hayes, he does those forms and that financial documentation. We hadn't heard anything. I assume that he got, that Dale had visited with him. Dale and I shared it last week, found out that he hadn't, so I sent a follow-up email to Mr. Alvin. He said that he hadn't done that yet, that he would get plugged in. That was the last that I had heard. Nathan was going to follow up. I'm assuming he's going to follow up with you, Dale. I had not received any additional information.
The vote be on the vote to table the resolution. All in favor of the table, please say aye.
Aye.
All vote same time. It's to the table. So it's zero down.
Thank you.
And can you, Ryan, follow up with Mr. Alvin and let him know that the table is on or receive the document? All the ordinance and resolution then. Next item is the attorney report.
That's the report, Your Honor.
Next item is the administrator and staff report.
The only report that I have is just to let you know that for those of you that were able to see the photo, and Chuck, you were on the same bus. You'll honor that's why you the crowd. Everybody, but hopefully everybody.
I told you exactly.
Yeah. Okay. Hopefully everybody gets a chance to see the photo.
Well, I told them.
If not, we can definitely send out pictures of me with all the parents. She loved you.
Oh,
my wife actually picked it.
What a
acting deal. Yeah, yeah. I was for an hour and a half. But just want to let you guys know that we did the first place. So, it's really sad. Really proud of the staff at the time. And I have Kalila, Shannon, Melissa, Jerry, Parks and Rec staff. Everybody spent a lot of time, especially Friday night fishing at that float. So, it was a great time where we see everybody in here. So, I'll pass that along to the mayor with everything else going on this weekend. We're doing this as well.
I'll cover it. Anything else with staff report? All right. Next item then is Board of Aldermen report from Tommy. Alderman Dodson.
A lot of great staff out there working and
did miss you, Ms. Debbie, but I lost my arm last week, so I missed it, so I want to thank Captain Bill and Ryan and anybody that supported me, and send condolences, so thank you guys so much, we really want to lose my arm. I had lots of my health issues, so, you know, I have battle cancer, you know, so thank you guys for all the support. To my family, thank you guys, so thank you.
Hope your children recover from the dog that you missed.
Yeah, that's on level, I love that. I'm not coming back because of your little stomping hurt and your... She's from the rest, she has gum in the ground, so she had a traumatized time, five pounds, so, the other next to the staff, the chief over here, she, was traumatized by the staff that was running down. Yeah, she doesn't go back to East St. Louis, I'm bad at home.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If East St. Louis is not bad, I'd be worried.
She has a good time, she has a good time, so thank you guys.
Putting that, don't make that fair, why do you have a good time up here?
The one that you want to walk on?
Oh, yeah. All running together, like 4 hours sleep. I went to a bottle of Aldermen, I think so far. Next up, I have a very report, want to say that, you know, we had a very successful day, just from what we can tell from the carnival attendance, and that was probably up 20% attendance-wise from what we had previous. And I talked to people from Liberty, Lanesta, lots of different towns. This was the first time they'd ever been in Grand Valley. And they were like, wow, you know, this guy's kind of centuries, but you guys, you know, are obviously growing. And Delta, they love the event. We back, you know, we brought it in with the chamber, because we took chances this year, brought it in since they had before, that were very popular. But really, I want to thank City staff, because you guys were out there Friday with us, you know. I thought Jerry was probably going to room me over at that block, I don't know how many times, about some good stuff, but, you know, Ken and his guys out there, from the Cooper and Centine up, and Ryan couldn't walk today, so he was he's still here, and, you know, Captain Bill and all he did, organizing everything, and police officers that work down there, and, you know, chief, I mean, it was a good time, and, you know, just see everyone having a good time in town, you know. I realized that, you know, we did get a couple of complaints in the dispatch on Saturday night, and it was too loud, so I had to turn it down. But, you know, we took care of that, so other than that, you know, great care, and I'm proud of everyone that helped out. And good time, and I hope that, you know, continues to grow, and part of the report next year. So, all I have, do we have any for the executive session?
Yes, personnel, real estate.
Okay. Fine, or Jay, we know. Aye. On Marlin, on Desley.